Romelu Lukaku, his first stint in the EPL for Chelsea, later went to West Brom, Everton, Manchester United, and went to Inter Milan. Now he's back into the EPL. Like they say, the king is back. But I would like us to discuss on the Footy Week podcast, how would Lukaku fare on his return to the EPL? Joining us from the US of A is Babatunde Idumu. He would like to, you know, air his opinion. But we start with Chimamaka. What's up? I know you're happy, you're buzzing, you're a Chelsea fan. It's good to have Romelu Lukaku back into the Chelsea fold. And we saw what he did a couple of hours ago, you know, scoring on his second debut with Chelsea against neighbors. Or against rivals, in London rivals, defeating Arsenal 2-0 at the Emirates Stadium. Do you think Lukaku is going to have a fairy tale in his return to the EPL?
Yeah, it now depends on your definition of fairy tale. All I know, all I have to say is Lukaku is going to have a swell time in the EPL. Why am I saying so? He has been in the EPL before. He has played with West Brom. He delivered with West Brom. He has played in Everton, he delivered in Everton, and he has played in Manchester United, where he also delivered in United, but his potentials were not appreciated. Okay. Now, finally, he's back in the EPL with Chelsea, who has pondered to have a number 9 in the frame of Diego Costa or Didier Drogba, and now we've gotten it. Now, it's on Chelsea's hand to lose Lukaku again, or play less of Lukaku, or not deliver with a striker in the mode of Lukaku. So he's welcome back to the EPL, and I can tell you he's going to fire on all cylinders. He's not going to be a flop of an overnight jersey we've had in the past. He's going to be a better one this time.
I can see Chimamaka buzzing. But to you, Tunde, I would like to disagree with Chimamaka the way he said he made an impact while he was at his first stint at Chelsea, and while he went to Everton, while he went to West Brom, and also Manchester United. Yes, we could say he made an impact there because he won the Europa League, despite not winning the title, the EPL title with Manchester United. But would you want to agree with Chimamaka about the stints in the other clubs while he was in the EPL, Chelsea, Everton, West Brom? Did he have any impact while he was there?
Yeah, his biggest impact in the Premier League, other than Manchester United, was what he did at Everton. At Everton, it was fantastic. At Everton, he became into who he is right now. You know, yes, he had to go to United and all of that, but the Lukaku that we know now, the Lukaku that we've come to see, and it has become one of the actually from everything that he did at Everton. So I want to agree that he's not new to the Premier League, of course. He knows everything, the ins and outs of the Premier League. And as a result of that, he has also come of age. He's at his prime. He's one of the best strikers in the world at the moment. And yeah, I do believe that he's going to have a fantastic season. And not just this season, I think going forward, he's going to be one to contend with. There are not many physically strong defenders in the Premier League, and he is going to have a field day in the league. I'm pretty sure of that. At least I believe he will.
Yeah, Tunde, you know, let us look deep into Lukaku's stats while he was at Manchester United. Did he score over 20 goals in the EPL? Did he score over 20 goals? Did he average over 20 goals? Because I remember while he was at West Brom, he averaged like 15, thereabouts, number of goals, while he was on loan at West Brom. But at Manchester United, I feel he got slagged there from the fans. People didn't really envy him while he was at Manchester United. I feel the expectation was bigger than what he expected. But him having to come back to the EPL, I would have loved for him to go back to Manchester United and just be able to correct his wrong. But I'm not in Lukaku's shoes. But he went straight over to Chelsea. So Chimamaka, like Tunde mentioned, he's gonna have a good return to the EPL. Do you relish Chelsea, Manchester United? Because I know Lukaku would have a statement to make when he faces his old owners Chimamaka?
Yeah, I'm here. Well, Lukaku's presence in the EPL actually is going to be a threat to the United team. It's good to know that they have also beefed up their defense. But as it stands, like I said earlier, Lukaku was less appreciated in Manchester United, mm-hmm. which gave him to make that move to Inter Milan, where he spent two seasons and was solely appreciated there. He was an outside striker. He played with a manager who loved everything and who could also correct his lapses. So Lukaku coming back is a polished Lukaku. So you like Tunde said earlier, he's one of the best number nines in the world as it stands, and I stand to be corrected. So Lukaku coming back to Chelsea only is only making a statement for himself, which he has always wanted. He's been a Chelsea fan actually, and I was watching some of his old documentaries when he said he would come Stamford Bridge to come and play football. He's been a fan. He's
I think we lost
Chimamaka. He's going to come and do better than me.
Okay, Shuma, we can hear you. You're back. Well, you're back. The gremlins almost took you away. Well, let's just move straight to Tunde. Chimamaka, just hold your thoughts there. Tunde, are you there? Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Lukaku, like I said, I'm sorry, just to correct the record, while he was at Everton, he scored 15 goals in 31 appearances. No, he scored 53 goals. He had two spells while he was at Everton, on loan at first, and the main one when he got signed, 53 goals in 110 appearances. But while he was on loan, he scored 15 goals out of 31 appearances. Moving to Manchester United, 28 out of 66. But really, as a Manchester United fan, why did you think, or what make you feel, why did Lukaku choose Chelsea?
Well, I don't think that Manchester United were interested in bringing him back, at least at this time. He stepped into a mold that was needed at United, but the pressure, and the pressure gets to everybody every once in a while. I think the pressure and the poor performance every once in a while was too much for him to cope with. And came right now, by the time he went to Inter Milan, he has built up confidence. He looks like he lost some weight, and he's fitter than he was at United. He looks ready to go than he was at United. So I don't think that at this very moment Manchester United were interested in bringing him back. But at the time he came, he did what he could do. I want to put it that way. I don't think he fulfilled. He lived up to the capacity, up to the hype, up to what was needed. But I think he did what he could do, and he just wasn't good enough at that time. And that was not that, even with what he did in Inter Milan this past season. I don't think it was enough to convince Manchester United. Even though they're looking for a number nine, I don't think it was enough to threw everybody off their horse that, hey, this striker is back. I don't think it was enough. But at the time he was at United, I don't think he did not live up to what was needed, and that's why he had to go. Right now, I would pay to have him back in the team, but he's not a priority at this very moment.
So back to Chimamaka. Chimamaka, are you there? Or the gremlins finally taking you away? So just for us to round off this episode, how many goals do you see Lukaku averaging?
In the EPL season, I see him doing 20-25. Between 20 and 25 goals.
Okay.
This EPL season, but in all competitions, he should be hitting over 30 goals this season. But in the EPL, should be between 20 and 25.
Tony,
that's a very very good errors number you're giving him. I would like to say that too, but I believe that the pressure of the Premier League would still come back. And so as a result of that, I would give him maybe between 15 to 20. He has the capacity. He's experienced enough and is really good to get to produce you up to 20. But I think that there will be injuries. I think that there will be times when he's off form or when he's trying to build back his confidence. I think all of those things will play a part. And so I give him 15 to 20 goals in the Premier League this season.
Well, for me, I don't. Lukaku is gonna have a very, very bumper season, bumper season. We saw a flash of it in today's game against Arsenal, and we saw how he was ready to take any defender on. Like you mentioned, there are no defenders that are muscular in the Prem EPL, and if he could do that to Holding and Mari today, I just want to watch the remaining next 5 games that Lukaku will feature. When I see him averaging over 20 goals, with the way he has started, coupled to the fact that if he gets injury-free, no itches and no injury sustained, he's going to average over 15 or 20 goals. So from us here, thank you very much, Tony, for joining us on today's episode. Thank you for our listeners for listening and watching in. Thank you.